Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Fireside Thoughts. Hey guys, welcome back to day number 3 of Fireside Thoughts. My name is Cody and I will be your host for today. Today we're going to be reading from Luke 1, 5, verse 7. It says, "In the time of Herod, king of Judah, there was a priest named Zechariah, who belonged to the priestly division of Abijah. His wife Elizabeth was also a descendant of Aaron. Both of them were upright in the sight of God, observing all the Lord's commandments and regulations blamelessly. But they had no children, because Elizabeth was barren, and they were both well along in years." In this passage, we meet two people. We meet Zechariah, and we meet Elizabeth. Now, in verse 5, it says that Zechariah was a priest, which means he represented his people before God in the temple. Some of his other duties may have included leading them in worship and leading them in doing things like offerings and giving sacrifices. We know that he was married to Elizabeth, and in verse 6, we read that him and Elizabeth were very meticulous in the way that they followed God and followed his way. However, in verse 7, we find out something really sad. In verse 7, we read that Zechariah and his wife Elizabeth are barren. They can't have any children. Now, to us, nowadays, that might seem like maybe a normal thing, but back in Luke's time, this would have been super shocking to the reader. Why, you ask? Well, it was because in that day, when people couldn't have kids, it was thought that God was punishing you for a sin that you had done. Now, a little bit of a spoiler alert, Elizabeth and Zechariah ended up having a child. They became pregnant with who we now know as John the Baptist, but more on that later. What we can recognize here from the passage is God working in ways that exceed our expectations. This childless couple, they would miraculously become the parents of a crucial partner in Jesus' life. But not yet. God was waiting to reveal his master plan to them. In the meantime, though, they had to deal with these unmet dreams and frustrated expectations. But they did so faithfully. And I think we can all learn something from that. Okay, now before I let you go, I want you to think about something. What is something in your life that you wanted really badly that God just didn't choose to provide for you? All right, guys, you can think about that for the next 24 hours, and we will see you again here tomorrow. Enjoy your day.